Creating a Trainz asset in Blender is a three-step process. First, you create your model. Next, you texture your model. And finally, you export your textured model from Blender to Trainz. Modeling uses a number of built-in tools, modifiers, and add-ons. They allow you to manipulate points known as vertices, edges that join two points, and faces that fill in the surface between three or more points. Tools can also achieve more complex manipulation of your model, such as smoothing surfaces. Built-in modifiers are sophisticated computer routines that allow you to further refine your model, such as smoothing some surfaces and not others. Add-ons are additional tools, some of which are built into Blender, while others are provided by third-party developers. Many third-party add-ons are available on the internet from Blender Market. Before you can paint your model, you need to unwrap it. Unwrapping is a process whereby the 3D surface of the model is laid out in two dimensions. The process is similar to the reverse of creating a dress, where the dress pattern is laid out on the two-dimensional material, the pieces cut out, and then sewn into the 3D garment. With Blender, the process is reversed. The 3D model is laid out into two dimensions. Blender add-ons are available to facilitate this process. Once the model's surfaces have been laid out in two-dimensional space, the model is ready for texturing. Up to 7 texture files, also known as maps, may be applied. Base color, height, normal, roughness, ambient occlusion, metallic, and emissive. Together, these files are known as a PBR material texture set. PBR is short for physically based rendering. The files contain information that determine not only color, but also whether the surface is smooth or rough, dull or shiny, has shadows in crevices, is metallic, or emits light. PBR material texture sets are available on the internet and may be downloaded for free. I like to use the Blender add-on PBR Painter to apply PBR material texture sets. The add-on integrates the process right into Blender. After separating the model into the surfaces that are to have different textures applied, the PBR material sets are added. When the model has been completely textured, the 7 PBR texture files need to be combined into 3 texture files for export to Trainz: base color, normal, and parameters. This is possible because each texture file is made up of four channels: a red, green, blue, and alpha channel. A color image usually has one file associated with it, the so-called base color file. The red, green, and blue channels contain information about each of the respective colors. And the alpha channel contains information about the degree of transparency of the image. Trainz, however, uses two more files. The new normal file combines the height information of the original normal file in the red, green, and blue channels. The height information of the height file is stored in the alpha channel. The parameter file stores emissive information in the red channel, roughness information in the green channel, ambient occlusion information in the blue channel, and metallic information in the alpha channel. These three texture files are exported to Trainz, usually in PNG format, along with the model's structural information in FBX format. To create a Trainz asset, upon opening Trainz, you select Manage Content. You can then select the Today filter. In the Developer menu, you select New Content. You then right mouse button select Reveal in Finder to open the asset file. To the asset file, you add the three texture files, base color, normal, and parameters. The base color file can also be called diffuse or albedo. You then add the FBX file containing the model data. You also need to add a thumbnail file. The thumbnail file is the image you see in N3V Game's download station. I like to add a generic file and then replace it with an image after I have imported the asset into Trainz. In the config.txt file, among other information, you give your asset a name, link the model data in the FBX file, and link the thumbnail file. All that's left to do now is to submit the edits, and the asset is ready to add to Trainz.